Hey everyone, and thanks for checking out another video. Today we're in Louisville, Kentucky at the Ford truck plant. We'll watch as the vehicles are loaded onto auto racks and crews ready to take the finished trucks to their next destination. I'll put timestamps in the description if you want to jump to the action. Here's a quick look around the facility. As you can see, trucks, and more trucks. Well, there are some SUVs too. And here we can see the auto racks ready to be loaded. There are 10 tracks capable of handling 15 auto racks each. They're separated into three groups of five. Here we can see what I assume are empties waiting for their next trip. At the end of the video, I'll show you some of the other lots filled with trucks as well. I'm also going to speed up this part of the video and skip some footage, but I'll put it all at the end in normal speed for you to check out. Well, back to the video. Now we can see the frames being used to make the trucks. My guess is that this yard doubles as holding tracks for the auto racks, but also allows parts and other things to be delivered to the facility. Here's another look at the facility. It really is massive. Here we get a better view of those auto racks. Like I said, they're loaded in sets of five. Here we see our first trucks being driven into the auto racks. There's a crew van that pulls between the cars. One by one, workers drive the trucks onto a ramp and then into the cars. During the loading process, there are connections between each auto rack so the workers can drive through several cars as they fill them up. They start at the top and then they'll go to the lower level. You can see a ramp at each segment. Look for the neon and you'll spot the crew who drive the trucks into the auto racks. Here, we'll see them pull out one after another. They'll head toward the loading area and then to where the trucks need to go. Check out how this dually gets into position to drive up on the ramp after letting another truck go ahead. These drivers must be good because that has to be a tight fit. And I'm sure one or two scratches and you're probably out of a job, or at least move to a different department. Well, let's check out the ramp closest to us. Here we see a truck driving up and disappearing into the auto rack, followed by another. Unfortunately, it was a very windy day, just like every day it seems like this spring, so I wasn't able to fly too far away and get a side view of the cars to show the connections between them. The audio doesn't do this justice, because you really could hear the cars creak and groan as these trucks made their way through them. I couldn't get an accurate count of how many crews were working, but there were at least three vans dropping drivers off at vehicles. My guess is there are at least one van for each section of auto racks. I knew how the vehicles were loaded into the cars, but never thought about getting them to the auto racks to be loaded in the first place. I am curious to know how they keep track of what vehicle goes where and where it's located in the massive parking lot. As we watch another set of trucks being loaded, notice how the ramp's now feeding the lower level of the auto rack. They made the move while we were following the drivers. As we skip ahead, notice the red taillights. The upper level of the auto rack is full, and now they need to adjust the ramp to the lower level. There's a control area on the left side of the ramp. Slowly but surely, the operator lowers the ramp and gets it into position to feed the bottom level. Check out the drivers climbing out of the auto rack. Their crew van is waiting for them between the cars. Off they go to get another round of trucks. A short time later and they're ready to load the lower level. I caught movement at the other end of the yard. It's a pair of locomotives that will be pulling out these auto racks. Looks like they're adding a third engine. Back to our end of the yard, we can see the workers trying to shut the doors on the auto racks. We also get a better view of the crew van. We'll jump ahead and watch another set of trucks being loaded. Looks like that last auto rack is full. Let's check out how they move the loading ramp to the next set of cars. That's pretty cool. He just drives it into position. He lines it up and then raises the ramp. As we lower the drone, we can see through the auto racks. Note the bright vest at the front of the section as the light catches him walking between the cars. About 6 minutes later, and the ramp is locked and loaded, ready to go. We'll watch as the first trucks load onto the ramp. This really does show how smart the people are who came up with this system. One after one, they drive up and through the cars. While we've been watching the ramp and the trucks loading, the engine crew's been busy. They've already connected and pulled out the first cut of auto racks. Now, they're getting ready to do the same on that second track. You can see the cars being pushed into the final section of auto racks. That third section is connected and then pulled out. I don't believe these cars are on yard air with how quickly they're able to connect and pull out. So maybe there are yard air hookups at the other end of the yard where they're being pulled into. I'm also not sure why this cut was pulled so far forward. Let's go take a look from the other end of the yard. By the time I was able to park and get the drone up, the crews were already working on the third set of auto racks. Each track has a fence and signage protecting it from any crews accidentally pulling in. As the crew pulls out this string of cars, notice those yellow lines. I'm assuming that's where each cut of cars can safely be pulled out to and not cause any obstruction or anything else. The conductor will pull the pin and uncouple these cars and allow the engines to pull forward. It looks like there is yard air in the facility, at least I think that's what the hose between the top and second track is. Now the crew's tying onto these two auto racks. As we follow along, they spot them in the last track of the loading yard. The locomotives then head to what I'm calling the storage yard. A battery change later and we can see three engines, including a neat switcher, unit number 1234. Then our locomotives come into view pulling a cut of cars from the storage yard. I'm not sure what they're doing here because it looks like they're putting those cars back into the same track they pulled them out of. They must be part of the train that's being put together and the crew just put them into that position ready to leave. Back to our locomotives, they're setting up to pull out the fourth cut of cars. Notice all the safety devices protecting the crews loading. There are blue flags, derail devices, flashing blue lights, stop signs, and fencing. A crew member walks over and will remove the derail devices on the 4 and 5 tracks, and he lays down the blue flag protections. The conductor then comes up and opens the fence gates. He checks the coupler and makes sure it's lined up. He then heads back to the engines and hops on. The connection is made, and a little while later, the locomotive starts pushing the autoracks to connect with the other two segments. Once everything's been hooked together, the crew pulls out the string of cars. They pull two cars past the yellow line, and then they separate those cars. Looks like those two auto racks are joining the other two that were set off earlier. Well, it's getting late and I have an hour and a half drive ahead of me. This was pretty fascinating to watch and see how each part is done. I'd love to hear what you think about the process. Did you know how all this was done? Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, clicking the like button would certainly be appreciated. I'd also like to give a big thank you to Jim Woods for supporting the channel. Jim, I really do appreciate it. Until our next trip, I hope you have a great day.